Gnome Sort is kinda a legitimate child of Insertion Sort and Bubble Sort. It behaves like Insertion Sort in its sorting approach, but compares and swaps adjacent items like Bubble Sort. Interestingly, it works with a single loop, but has a quadratic time complexity. We have a video for Insertion Sort and another one for Bubble Sort. If you're interested, here are the links. But for now, let's see how Gnome Sort works and what is its time complexity. The idea is comparing two adjacent items. If they are in the correct order, it goes one step forward. If not, it swaps them and goes one step backwards. It's plain to see that it might compare two items multiple times. No wonder why it was originally named a stupid sort. It continues doing that until it cannot go any step further, and that's when we can be sure that the array is fully sorted. Without wasting time, let's jump into the code. But before that, please like this video if you think it's useful and informative, and consider subscribing to the channel. The algorithm is simple. We define a variable to keep track of where we are in the array and do the following steps over and over while the defined variable is less than the size of the array. If we are at the first element or if two adjacent items are in the correct order, go one step forward. Otherwise, swap the items as they are in the wrong order and go one step backwards. Clearly, the algorithm doesn't contain any nested loops, so at the first glance, it might seem it's in an order of n. But that's not true, as we might go backwards in the array as well. Let's count the number of comparisons when the input is already sorted, and when it's sorted in reverse order. The best case is when the input is already sorted, so the number of comparisons is in an order of n. However, when it's reversely sorted, the number of comparisons grows much faster. Indeed, Gnome Sort has the worst case and the average case of n squared, and in practice, it's even slower than Insertion Sort. Thank you for watching the video. If you find it useful, please like it. In this channel, we try to create high-quality videos about data structures, algorithms, and programming. If you're interested in these topics, please consider subscribing.